Hi, I'm a banana, and today we're going to learn about slope. Now here we have some examples of slope. Slope is a characteristic of lines that tells us how much a line's going up versus how much is it traveling in a horizontal direction. So here's our first slope. This green line right here has a positive slope. We know that because if we look at it from left to right, we see it's increasing. So for example, this slope might be 2/5, positive 2/5. This next slope, looking from left to right, is going down. So we say this is a negative slope. An example of a negative slope would be -2. Now there's two strange slopes we encounter. Here's the first one, no slope. From left to right, we see the line is not going up or down. So we say this is a slope of 0 or no slope. You know you have a no slope situation when you're calculating slope and you end up with a 0 in your numerator. If you have 0 divided by 4, that's just 0, so this would be no slope. The last case is if we have a vertical line like this. We call this slope undefined. We know we have an undefined slope when you're calculating slope and you have something like 3 divided by 0. That can't be done, so we call this undefined. Now let's talk about how we actually calculate slope. Here's an example with another green line. Now we already know this slope is positive from what we learned just a second ago, but let's figure out how can we actually calculate the slope. The slope is exactly the ratio of rise over run in a line. So we need to figure out how much this line rises and how much does it run. So let's figure out rise. From this point to this point, it looks like we rise 1, 2, 3, 4. We go up 4. Now, as we're going up 4, how much do we run? It looks like 1, 2, 3. So to get from this point to this point on the line, we had to rise 4 and run 3. So we say our rise is 4 and our run is 3. The slope of this line is actually 4/3. And slope is often abbreviated with an m. So we say m equals +4/3 for this line. So using this and this, we can kind of see what our calculation or our formula for slope is. Slope, or m equals rise over run. That's one way to calculate it. This is very useful if you have a graph of the line already. Another way to calculate slope is using this formula. Slope equals y(2) - y(1) all over x(2) - x(1). This may look very complicated, but it's not that bad. Let's look at an example calculating slope this way. Here we have two points. Let's call this point 1 and this point 2. And we're going to try to calculate the slope of the line running between those points. Since this is point 1, this is the x-coordinate of point 1. And this is the y-coordinate of point 1. Here's the x-coordinate of point 2 and the y-coordinate of point 2. Now we can start to see how we can use these numbers in this formula over here. All we're going to do is match each of these components with this formula, and we'll be able to calculate the slope. So let me copy the formula again. Slope equals y(2) - y(1) all over x(2) - x(1). Matching these pieces with what we have in our actual points, y(2) is 5 minus y(1), which is 2, all over 1 - 3. Doing these simple calculations, 5 - 2 = 3, and 1 - 3 = -2. We end up with the fraction -3/2. That means the slope of the line that connects these two points is -3/2. Good luck.